Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Okay. Praise God. Just got notification that my mic was muted. Oh, no. But anyway, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Wanted to let everybody know that we were having a little bit of technical difficulty here. But now it appears that that has been resolved. Thank you, Father. Praise you, Jesus. Father God, we pray in the name of Jesus for the power of the Holy Spirit to come down and touch every single person this evening. We pray for an outpouring of your faith, Father God, to touch every single person, every believer that is stepping forward and calling into the show. We pray in the name of Jesus for an abundance of supernatural faith and the healing power of Jesus Christ to flow through the prayers and the words of Brother Wagner this evening, and through those of us who are joining us on the show tonight to join us for the prayers of the saints. Father God, we lift you up. We glorify your holy name. We pray for your power, Jehovah Rapha, to move upon the people, Father God, in Jesus' name. Thank you, Father. Amen. Now, we got some folks. I wanted to let you know that we have – I'm watching the Q console for the radio program, the electronic board, if you will. And I do see some calls coming in and then dropping back off. Now, what that usually indicates, praise Jesus, is that we're having some, you know, technical challenges on the internet and all that with the voiceover IP circuitry and all the kind of, you know, electronic gizmos and gadgets that run the system at the headquarters up there at Blog Talk Radio. Now, that being said, please hang in there and be perseverant. I saw an international call with the last four of 7304 pop in, not once, but twice, and then drop off both times. So, and there's been other calls that has happened to as well. So, folks, sorry about that. That is absolutely beyond our control, but we can continue to pray. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we pray for you to just touch and supernaturally protect and wrap your holy fire around every wire, every electron, everything that makes this program possible. And we praise you for that, Father God. We ask you for a holy fire, a hedge of protection around everything that makes this show possible, that we can touch people's lives with your glory and with your grace. Father God, we praise you. We ask you for a whirlwind of the Holy Spirit to encircle every single person this evening. Father, those who pray along with us, we ask you, Father God, in the name of Jesus, to make them profitable servants unto the kingdom. We are all in this together, and it is the power of Christ through us all combined in corporate prayer that makes these things possible. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. And on that note, let's bring on brother and pastor Aaron Wagner. Glory to Jesus.
Oh, he touched me.
Pastor Aaron, are you there?
Yes, sir, I am. You can hear me?
Oh, praise God. Yep, I can hear you. Yeah, we were having
Hallelujah.
A little bit of a bumpy start there, but, you know, hey, who doesn't enjoy a little bit of dead air once in a while, huh?
Yeah. It was so funny. I'm like, I don't know if I should cover you because I didn't know I was not hearing you speak and you're already speaking and I didn't want to talk over you. It was kind of an interesting situation.
It's a constantly changing what they refer to as an emerging technology, but it does make it possible for boneheads like me to travel around from place to place and do my day job and at the same time be able to do shows remotely. So it's a pretty cool technology, but here's a lot of buttons and gizmos and gadgets and, you know, it's just little old me, and I make lots of mistakes. Ask anybody who knows me. I'm the king of mistakes. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I'm glad our Father lets those who make mistakes and that are imperfect into heaven. Otherwise, I wouldn't have a shot. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. God's grace is so amazing. Man, it sounds like the office is busy over there, huh?
Yeah, praise God. We do have a pretty full switchboard. The number that I gave you earlier has doubled. But again, there have been some dropouts. But praise Jesus, you know, this is great. This is what we're asking for. This is what I've been praying for. You know, there's been I received a supernatural. I didn't tell you about this because you're just so busy. You're almost – I'd say you're even busier than me. And when for me to say that, that's amazing. Because, like, I have to schedule time to, like, sit on my recliner, you know, and take a break.
Yeah, well, I don't know about that, but I know that God's grace is sufficient for us.
Amen. Amen. Praise God.
But I usually get to sit down around 10 o'clock and have dinner.
Oh, yeah, yeah. There are those times when, you know, I'm like, oh, no, the show's going to start. I had a long day. I'm like, oh, man, and when I'm on the road, it's like, oh, my gosh. You know, there have been times when I was, like, skidding on snow, trying to make it back to the hotel. I had 30 minutes left before to get started, and oh, it's just incredible. But the Lord does come through. And, you know, patience and perseverance, that seems to be one of the most key elements or attributes in our walk. The guest that we had, Pastor Masih from Pakistan, who went through hell on earth and ultimately led to him making it into the United States and starting a ministry here. But his testimony was amazing, and he was actually the Lord put him into a place where he was commanded by the Father to lay hands on a dead man in front of a whole big room full of people in Pakistan. I think it was Pakistan, either there or South Africa. I think it was Pakistan, though. And you know how the Father is, and when you read the scripture, you see this dynamic where when a person steps out in faith, you know, rise up and walk, you know, when that person takes that initiative, when they reach out to touch the hem of the robe of Jesus, when, you know, by your faith, let it be so, you know, it's a combination of the faith of both the person who's doing the praying and the person who's receiving the prayer most of the time, but not always. There's always supernatural exceptions to that rule. And it was fascinating with Pastor Masih. He was standing over this person, the father, a dead person. They were all, oh, no, very much like the story in the Bible, crying and very upset. And the Lord told him to lay hands on that person and command that person to rise up. And he was like, in the name of Jesus. And he's in front of all of these, you know, people that don't believe, unbelievers. And which goes to show you, there's the exception to the rule, you know. He's right there saying, in the name of the Lord Jesus, in the name of the Lord Jesus, I command you to rise up. And the person didn't, nothing happened. And he's like, Lord, you know, what am I supposed to do? And God says, keep praying. And he's like, oh, no. And he's like, okay. So he goes back and he's like, in the name of the Lord Jesus. And he's like praying fervently, in the name of Jesus, rise up and walk, get up in Jesus' name. And the person doesn't move. Nothing happens. Nothing. And this is going on, I guess, for about four cycles, you know, where he's praying and praying and praying. And the Father keeps saying, keep praying. And he's like, but Lord, in his spirit, you know, he's talking to the Lord and he's going, but Lord, don't you see, if I keep on praying and this person doesn't get raised from the dead, look at the people in this room. This is going to be a bad situation. And the Father told him, keep praying. And he goes, okay. And he goes, in the name of the Lord Jesus, rise up and walk. And the person rose from the dead right in the room. And everybody in the whole facility just flipped out. And that's kind of how our God works. I don't understand it. I don't pretend to understand it. But that concept of patience and perseverance and unstoppable faith is an element that seems to be a major contributor toward the power moving through us and causing the healing to occur. It's not only the laying on of hands when that's possible, of course. It's not possible through a show like this unless we have somebody standing in proxy or, you know, for that individual on their behalf. But yes, it's so exciting because you can't give up. You can't give up. You know, like Curry Blake says, he starts at one side. He'll have a row of people right up in front of the church, and he'll go walk up and he'll lay hands. He says, okay, what is your problem? I have this. Okay, that's all I need to know. In the name of the Lord Jesus, spirit of infirmity, get out in Jesus' name. I command it. And that person go boom, they go out in the spirit, and a couple of people grab him and lay him down. Then he goes to the next person. What is your problem? What is your ailment, sir? Well, I have this thing in my – that's all I need to know. In the name of the Lord Jesus, be thou made whole in Jesus' name. The person doesn't move. He just stands there. In the name of Jesus, be healed, I command you. And the person just stands there. And he says, I'll be right back. He goes right down to the next person. He keeps on going. He says, the way he looks at it is he goes, I figure I'll just keep on going down the line and circling back until they receive their healing in Jesus' name. Praise God.
Yeah, yeah. Amen. You know, that's what it's about, John. Actually, I had a conversation with the Lord, and I'm so thankful for it because God reminded me just recently. Because you have to understand, this is, even though I meet with many people over the phone and pray with people in that aspect,
This is still new to me because I'm the type of guy, I want to lay hands on you. Cause like I say, when I lay hands on you, you know, you get to see the power hit them and they go down and they get up healed. And the Lord reminded me, he said, you have to remember, it's not your prayer. It's never your prayer that will heal them. And I'm like, okay, so that's right, because the Lord has been teaching me that faith is not, it's not a hit or miss or win or lose. It's not a time. It's not a certain time. It's not a point in time. It's when we speak and we speak to the mountain, we tell it to what it needs to do, and then we stand on faith and we don't doubt. Doubt actually doesn't mean to have a bad thought. It means to turn away and to pull your faith away. So what you see Curry Blake doing is when he's praying and he's healing, he's praying for healing and he's going down the line, everything that we do, every type of power that of God that is moved by faith. So when you start praying for people and it's something so easy and you've seen it so many times, you gain faith for that. Like if somebody, if somebody has a short leg and I set them down, like I don't have any question of whether or not that leg's going to grow. I'll blow on it. I'll point at it and it's going to come out. Why? I believe it's just because I've seen it so many times and I have a certain faith for that. I believe it with all my heart and it happens every time. However, there may be things I haven't seen yet. So, when I'm praying for someone and I'm kind of going down the line as I'm touching people and praying for people, that my faith is being built. So when I come back to that guy, now all of a sudden I have this momentum going with this faith that is behind it, that is so powerful that now the man is being healed by something that he couldn't, which I didn't have faith for before, because like I say, you kind of gain momentum. And also we have to understand that when if I pray for you, especially over this show, if I pray for you and you know, you don't instantly feel anything, maybe you're not even healed, you know, that time that we pray. We're standing on that. We're believing. We're still, as long as we hold on to that faith and we're believing, like I tell people, the only reaction to this is not, God, why not me? What happened? Why can't I get healed? Did I do something wrong? Are you upset with me? No, it's the only reaction to when somebody prays this, Father, I thank you that that man of God prayed for me. I thank you that that man of God laid hands on me. I thank you for this opportunity, and I'm believing, God, because you're so faithful. Your word is true over my circumstances. Your word is true over what I'm feeling, and God, I know that you're doing something in me, especially when you get to feel that warmth or a tingling. Just yesterday, I met this guy. It was so awesome because I've been praying for him, but I didn't even know him. Somebody brought him to my attention. I started praying for him, and I was helping somebody with their car, and this guy comes walking by, and I go introduce. He's like, "Yeah, I'm so and so." I'm like, "What? Really? Wow!" And I said, "I knew that God wanted me to do a work." So instantly, I'm starting to listen in my heart to see if there's anything wrong with him. God starts telling me, "Yeah, he's in pain," and I can, without any type of word of knowledge or anything, you could tell the guy was in pain. So I can't really say for sure that it was a word of knowledge, but I know it was his back. And so we talk a little bit, and I go over and I set him down, and sure enough, he's got one leg that's really short, so grew out because he had some problems in his lower back. But then we stand up and we're just talking, and I said, "Man, can I just pray for you, man? I just want to pray. I just feel like God wanting to heal your heart, man. You know, your back, I believe your back's being, you know, touched by God, but I believe God wants to do something in your heart. Can I just pray?" "Yeah, man, no problem." So I just said, "All right, God, I just thank you for this brother. I thank you that you love him." And I wasn't thinking of what I was doing, and I just lay my hand on his head. Just barely, just not even, didn't even lay my hand, just barely touched his head. And the man goes, "Wow!" And we're standing on concrete. He starts falling back. I'm like, "Oh, it's okay, brother. Just go, just go, just go." Oh, I knew God was gonna hold him back or hold him up. So, but when you see that, and when you know something like that is, when something like that happens, like, what are you thinking? You're thinking God touched this man, so now you got faith that's backing up what just happened. Now, even if I don't see it, I still have to believe it because we walk by faith and not by sight.
Amen.
Wow. anyway, so I don't know where that came from, but yeah, that's good stuff.
Yeah, praise Jesus. All right, well, Are you ready? Because we got a pretty good call queue right now. Praise God. And also for you folks out there that that hadn't been disconnected or whatever, I was writing down numbers as fast as I could as they were connecting the moment the show music started. So I will try to get you as quick, you know, in the order that you called in, even though you may have been disconnected. So sorry about the technology issues. Praise Jesus. But are you ready, brother?
Yes. Let me just mention one other thing. Everybody, remember, everything that God does is by grace. You don't deserve it. You cannot deserve it. You cannot earn it. Let God touch you by grace tonight. Let you touch him by mercy. Don't feel like because you've been a Christian for 15 years that you deserve to be healed. You can come into this thing without knowing anything about God and just be touched by mercy. Okay? So just remember, it's all grace. It's all mercy. And when we pray, just be thankful for your healing. Don't say, well, why not me, God? Why? Don't even let that cross your mind. Just thank him for the healing. Thank him for what he's doing. Thank him for the show. And I, like I said, I prayed for people, and the next day they were healed because we stood on faith. Yeah,
amen.
Go ahead, John.
God. All right. And we're going to go ahead and bring on the first caller with the last four digits of their phone number is 0304. 0304, you're on live with Pastor Aaron Wagner.
Hello.
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 Yes,
hello.
We got you. Go ahead.
We good?
Yep. Little echo.
Okay, he dropped. He's been having he's disconnected about three times. Praise Jesus. We'll just I'll just keep
calling,
on
brother.
Yeah, keep calling. Praise God. All right, now I'm looking for the next one that called in. Okay, hallelujah. Here we go. 1035. Last four. You're on live with Pastor Aaron Wagner. 1035. All right. Hello. All right. Praise God. All right. We're going to go ahead and put 1035 on hold. We're going to go to the next one. Praise Jesus. All right. Hallelujah. Here we go. The last four of this caller is 5882. Again, that's 5882. You're on the show live with Pastor Aaron Wagner.
Hey, that's me.
Hey, praise God.
Hey, John.
Hi, how are you? Crystal, this is Pastor Aaron Wagner. God bless you.
Hey, thank you. This is my first time calling in.
Wonderful. We like first timers. How you doing?
I'm doing okay.
Praise God. What can we pray for you for?
I have struggled with a continuous sin over and over and over with an eating disorder. And I had my friend Nancy prayed over me about 2 weeks ago, and she cast out a spirit of anger along with a spirit of gluttony. And so I did well for a couple of days, but that is back with a roaring vengeance.
Okay, so you're telling me that you're having, when you say eating disorder, you're eating too much? And then, you know, bringing it back up. Is that what you're saying?
Yeah.
Okay. And in your heart, and you're doing that because you want to be able to eat more without actually dealing with the consequences.
Yeah, I think that started a long time ago, but I think at the root of that, God is showing me that there's self-hate.
Okay. So, I'm sorry, what's your first name, Crystal?
Yeah, that's it.
Okay, praise God. Crystal, so let me just reiterate something for you, okay? Because what does the Bible say? The Bible says you will know the truth and the truth will make you free. So truly what makes you free is knowing the truth. And the way that we know the truth is, number one, you've got to see your potential. See, God sees you for your potential, your destiny, your created value. He sees through all that garbage and he says, wow, she's so precious. I love her. She's beautiful. He sees you through the finished work of the cross. So he sees you as his daughter, and you are so valuable and so amazing that, you know, that he would shed his blood for you, that he sent his son to die for you. He allowed heaven to go bankrupt to get you back. You need to understand who you are in the kingdom of God is so special. There should be no reason ever for you to lack self-confidence. ever. You should never feel, you know, unworthy or, you know, allow yourself to have any self-hate, because God says you're so amazing that he would die for you, that you are, you know, you are created in his image in the very beginning. The Bible says, I know we say, well, man was created in the image of God, but the Bible says male and female, he created them in his image. So you're created in the very beginning in the image of God. Now, sin twisted that up. That's true. But that doesn't change the fact of your eternal destiny. You're predestined to be conformed in the image of Christ. You're predestined to be righteous in the eyes of God, blameless and, you know, without blame. And he sees you that way. So really what we need to do is I need you to get and understand, I need you to understand who you are. I need you to understand how valuable you are to God, into the kingdom of God. And it doesn't matter what you've done before, because Christ is risen. The stone is rolled away. Nothing else matters. Who cares what happened before? Allow yourself to live from the finished work of the cross, the place where now all of a sudden you've been crucified with Christ. You no longer live, but Christ lives through you. It doesn't matter who accepts you anymore, because you're accepted by God. You're accepted in the beloved. And don't allow your circumstances to potter you and make you give your identity. Don't allow what things happen around you or what people say about you make your identity. Allow your identity to come from what God says about you, what the Word says about you. Because you are beautiful and you're amazing to God. He loves you so much. I wouldn't even be able to describe in any language the love that he has for you. No matter what you've done, dear, no matter what you've done, no matter how you've acted, none of that matters. You go before God and you tell him, Lord, I accept your mercy. I accept your forgiveness. I am your beloved. And because I am your beloved, I will walk with peace. I will walk in the newness of life. And I will not allow myself in any way to pull myself down or to drag myself down or to hold my head down any longer. Because Jesus is Lord, because you are Lord, you are God, and I am your daughter. Does that make sense?
It does.
See, sweetheart, that's what it's about. It's not so much about you needing some deliverance. It's not about you needing this great deliverance. And if we can do a deliverance, and that's fine. But it's about a perspective. Don't let your perspective get twisted. Because if your perspective says, my worth and my value and who I am comes from him. It's not about what you're going through. It's what he went through. And if you're having a problem with eating and, you know, and you want to eat, then you have to understand that God's grace is sufficient for that. You can, first of all, God's not up there damning gluttons. There's a lot worse things going on than gluttony. Not to say it's okay. But what I'm saying is God's giving you grace for that. Don't allow yourself to be condemned. Don't allow the enemy to hold you down and pull you back because of this thing you're dealing with. No, just go before the Lord and tell the Lord, Lord, look, I've been living in my flesh too long, and I want to live in the spirit. See, it's your flesh that's craving these things. I just read in James today, it says that we are enticed by our desires. Well, if your desires are fleshly, you're going to be drawn and tempted for the things of the flesh. But if you move over into the spirit and you begin to read the word of God and sit in a room alone with no one else around and say, God, here I am with your word and I want to know you. God, here I am. I'm your daughter and you said I'm your daughter and you said you love me. God, show me how you see me. Show me who I am and make me walk in that identity. Help me to walk in that identity. And you tell him everything I've gone through, everything I was before, I'm just leaving it at the feet of the cross. I'm leaving at the feet of Christ, and I'm just taking on what you say about me. I'm taking on the identity that comes from knowing you and being in Christ. And guess what? Grace will come down and go wham and set you free. Because go ahead. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to cut you off.
I was going to say, that's what I want. That's what I've been missing.
Right.
Experiencing that.
Right. Here's what you're missing. You're only missing what you believe you're missing. Because don't allow what you believe to go off of what you're seeing, what you're experiencing. Never let it go off of experience. Never let what you believe be based on experiences. And when you see people around you and they're getting rocked by God, you don't want to be like, well, why ain't I getting that? Because it's not about what every person is going to experience God in a different way. You have to understand that, first of all. And then second of all, you have to understand whether or not you ever feel God's love, the fact is he still loves you. If you never feel his presence, the fact is he's with you and he'll never leave you nor forsake you. But here is my promise to you as a man of God. And I wouldn't just say this. Here is my promise to you. If you get alone with God in the secret place and you seek him, as he told me, every person has as much of you or as much as me of me as they want. God's not hiding from you. He's not holding anything back from you. You can have as much of God as you want, but you have to prove to him and show him that you are desiring him. And don't let it be about church. Don't let it be about even Christianity. Let it be about a relationship between your daddy and you, your papa and you, your father and you, Abba. Let it be about that. Jesus didn't die to get you into heaven just to get you into heaven. He died to get heaven back into you so you can have intimacy, fellowship, and relationship with the Father. So he is the way to the Father. So get to know your Father, and out of knowing him, such revelation of who you are. And I mean, this is good because you're not the only one struggling with this. Many, many, many people, Christians, are struggling with this, and it's not okay. It's not something that you should struggle with anymore because it's a lie from the pits of hell. You're amazing, and God loves you, and he says you're so valuable. So valuable, he allowed heaven to go bankrupt to get you back. So what I want you to do, do you have me on speakerphone?
No, I don't.
Can you put me on speakerphone?
I can.
Please.
Okay, you're on speaker. Now,
I want you to lift up your hands and pray with me, okay? Say, Father.
Father.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
I come before you.
I come before you.
In repentance. In repentance.
In repentance.
And I offer myself wholly to you.
And I offer myself wholly to you.
I want to know you.
I want to know you.
And I ask you, forgive me.
I ask that you would forgive me.
For me not seeing you for who you are.
For me not seeing you for who you are.
Or seeing myself for who I am.
Or seeing myself for who I am.
Help me to love myself.
Help me to love myself.
So I can become love and love others.
So I can become love and love others.
And Father, I receive your grace.
And Father, I receive your grace.
And your love.
And your love.
And I receive all of you I can have.
And I receive all of you that I can have.
So Jesus, come.
So Jesus, come.
Pour into me.
Pour into me.
And restore to me.
And restore to me.
The joy of my salvation.
The joy of my salvation.
Okay, now I'm going to pray. In Jesus' name, I command peace in the heart right now. I command that passes all understanding to guard her heart and her mind through Christ Jesus. Devil, I bind you by the power of the Spirit of God in Jesus' name. Any unclean spirits that is hindering this woman in any way, your time is up. You will leave and you will not come back. Go right now. It's over for you. I command fire in her belly, fire in her heart right now in Jesus' name. Thank you, Papa. Thank you, Father. Thank you for your fire, God. Come, Jesus, come. Fill her up with your love. Show her your mercy, God. Show her your presence and your goodness, Father. You spirit of disorder, eating disorder, you spirit, I command you, leave her now. You spirit of the flesh, I break your power and I cancel your assignments. It's over. Every unclean spirit, leave. Jesus is Lord.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. You feeling him?
I do.
He loves you, okay? That's his presence.
Thank you.
Do you promise me that you're going to get alone with him?
I do. I promise.
Oh, okay. You get alone with him for a week. Every opportunity you get, you go and get alone with him when no one else is around, and you say, Father, I'm here to know you. I'm seeking you. Reveal yourself to me. God, I don't care what I've had in the past. I'm not satisfied. I want more. I want to know you, Father, and pray this way. Pray, Father, I thank you that you love me. I thank you for my value. I thank you for my eternal destiny. Worship him, praise him, and thank him for what he's already done. Don't cry and pray as somebody who lacks identity and lacks value. And pray what you want and to be and what you want to believe, and grace will come down and allow that to come on you and allow that change to be made in you, because that's what God's grace is, the transforming power of God. Okay, so Father, I just ask you to keep pouring out on my sister as we leave her now. I ask you just keep pouring out on her. I ask Holy Spirit that you would just commune with her and show her who she is. And I thank you, God, that this disorder is crushed because Jesus is Lord. I thank you that from this day forth that her body will no longer crave anything that it's not needed, anything that is not needed. No more cravings of anything that is not needed in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Father. Thank you, God. And I pray right now for healing. I thank you, God, for healing of the stomach and healing of the esophagus and anything else that is damaged from this eating disorder. The sin is forgiven, so the effects of this sin must depart in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Amen. Bless you, sister.
Thank you.
I know I know that your question and your inquiry helped a lot of other people too. So God bless you. Thank you for being humble and stepping out and being honest. God bless you.
Thank you.
You're welcome. We love
Praise
you,
Jesus. Sister Crystal, before you go, how are you doing with that spirit of anger that you've had? Is that gone, or
it
are you
is.
Still dealing with that?
It is. It's gone.
It is gone. Praise God. Thank you,
it's
Jesus.
Gone.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Amen. Father, we just thank you. We thank you for your power. We thank you for your peace. We thank you for your outpouring of the Holy Spirit. Father God, we call down a spirit of fire upon her to surround her with a holy fire, a hedge of protection. Father God, let not the unclean spirits touch her again in Jesus' name. We claim it. Hallelujah. Thank you so much, Crystal, for calling tonight. God bless you.
Glory.
Thank you. Thank you.
Praise Jesus.
Oh, he touched me.
Praise God. 0304, last four. 0304, are you there?
Yes, hello. Yes, hello.
Yep, you're online with Pastor Aaron Wagner.
Hi, Pastor Aaron. How are you?
I'm amazing, sir. Thank you for asking. How are you?
I'm doing better since I got able to talk to you already.
Praise God. Glory.
Well, let me say that. I have tinnitus, and I've had this for 17 years. I've seen various doctors, specialists, and basically they say there's nothing they can do for me. And I've kind of been suffering in silence, if you would, all these years.
Okay.
So I'd love to give this over to the Lord and have him take care of it for me.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Okay, so just a quick question. I don't want to know, you know, all your symptoms or anything, but what exactly is tinnitus? Is that in the blood?
No, it's actually noises that are heard ear, high-pitched noises in both
that's
ears.
That's right. Okay, that's right.
And it's a continuing thing. It doesn't really let up.
Okay. All right. So yeah, let's get that stopped. That's definitely something that we don't want you to have to deal with anymore. Am I on speakerphone?
Yes.
Okay. So don't cover your ears, but just go ahead and lay your hands on your ears. Just, you know, maybe fingers or something so you can still hear me.
Yes.
All right. I'm sorry. First name again?
Ken.
Tim?
Ken. K-E-N.
Oh, Ken. Okay, sorry. Okay. Father, in Jesus' name, I thank you for Ken, God, and I thank you that you love him so much. Father,
yes,
thank you for your Holy Spirit that is there. Thank you for your Holy Spirit that is ready to work. Right now, devil, I bind you by the power of the Spirit of God in Jesus' name. I command you, spirit of tinnitus, I command you, go right now. All noise, stop in Jesus' name. I command the fire of God right now from the top of the head to the bottom of the feet in the name of Jesus. Why does this noise have to stop? Why does tinnitus have to go? Because Jesus Christ is Lord. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. Cease right now in Jesus' name. Every unclean spirit, I command you to bow and flee right now as if in stark terror. Jesus is Lord. Go! Thank you, Father. What's going on?
Well, I kind of feel like a warmth. That's the only way I can explain it. That's going on in my area of my ears.
Praise God. That's what we wanted. Awesome.
Thank you, Lord.
Awesome. So remember, your response, thank you for my healing. Thank you that Jesus is Lord.
Healing, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
Yeah.
Praise
you, Lord. You've been filled with the Spirit? Praise God. All right, so in Jesus' name, all of this hearing must be restored. All this noise must stop, and that's all there is to it, for Jesus is Lord. God, thank you for what you're doing. Amen. Bless you, brother. I'm going to let God finish you off, and then let us know what happens, and you just keep contacting us if you need to.
Yes, Pastor. Thank you so much, and God bless you and Brother John as well.
God bless you,
all right,
brother.
Thank you. God bless you, bro.
Praise Jesus. Hallelujah. Right, praise God. And now the last four, 1035. 1035, you're on live with Pastor Aaron Wagner. Are you there?
Hi, John. John, hi. Hi.
I'm
just listening in. I don't think I pressed one. I just called to listen.
Yeah, on the that's okay. On the live shows, we don't, you know, there's too many people that could miss their blessing if I
oh.
was. Yeah, so. Have to believe that. Yeah, no problem. You can listen as much as you want. Praise Jesus. We'll move to the next person. God bless you. Praise God. 7511, last four. You're on live with Pastor Aaron Wagner. You're on live.
Praise God. 7511, last four. You're on live with Pastor Aaron Wagner.
And we're believing that person's going to answer their phone. Okay. Praise Jesus. Okay, 7511, going once, going twice. Praise Jesus. All right, we're going back on hold with 7511. All right, we'll circle back. Let's see here. Let's look for the next person. Okay, 9225, last four. Thank you for holding so long. You're on live with Pastor Aaron Wagner. 9225. Okay, wow. We must have a lot of callers, brother, that are just listening in on the program. Praise Jesus. All right, so let's go ahead and move on to the next caller. Let me go ahead and cycle down through these numbers. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Hallelujah.
Oh, he touched me.
All right, praise God. And now we move on to last 42017. Are you there?
Yes, I'm here.
All right, praise God. You're on live with Pastor Aaron Wagner.
Hi. The reason I'm calling is because I've been dealing with, like, depression for a couple of years. And I think it turned into, like, PTSD. The reason being that 6 years ago I moved from the U.S. to Mexico with my husband, and then the reason he wanted to move here was because he didn't want to go through the divorce in the U.S. and have to split assets with me. So there's that. Now, we're going to get divorced, and now he's, like, threatening that he's going to take the kids away and that I have to move out of the house. He's like almost living with a woman, and I don't know. There's just weird things that she does, like witchcraft, and then I'm also like blocked. Like when I was 14 years old, I almost got abducted by aliens, and Jesus saved me. I mean, I've seen
wow.
supernatural stuff. And I'm blocked. And I am on my way to hell if I don't do anything.
So let me ask you a question. What do you want God to do for you as far as your marriage goes? Do you want it to be restored? Are you willing to work on it? Or is he gone with you? You're married, correct?
Yeah, I'm married. I've been holding on for so long. I think it was all these years I made him my idol, and I wanted to work it out. And
How long have you been separated? Sorry.
4 years.
But it's been going on for 4 years.
Like, we lived apart, and then I thought, like, last year that he would, you know, settle in, and all of a sudden he drives into the driveway in this person's car, and now out of the blue, you've been replaced. And I had forgiven him in the past. He has, I think, alcoholism and an addiction. I'm kind of messed up too, being codependent. But I don't think I want the marriage.
Mm-hmm.
I want just things to be better for my kids. My daughter has hatred for him, and I am so angry that
okay.
they have to go through this too.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So I understand that what he has done has, been really hard for you. And I understand, that you have went through some different seasons of, anger and bitterness and things like that. But, I think a lot of times that when we pray and when we allow ourselves to pray from a motive of selfishness, to where, now just bear with me, I'm just telling you the truth because I love you and care about you, okay? And what happens is we begin to say, We pray as in, I can't believe he's done this to me. I can't believe he's, you know, he cheated on me. He did this to me after so many years of marriage. And God, why would he do this to me? And God, if you're there, why aren't you helping me? Why aren't you fixing this? You know, we begin to, number one, we begin to pray from a motive of selfishness. Number two, we begin to blame God for everything. And really what we should be doing is praying in this way. Father, I thank you that you love him. Lord, I know he's done so many things that are not okay, God, but it's because he doesn't know who he is. Because you have to understand, your husband is in great danger. He is messing with fire. He's playing with fire. And you know as well as I do that God will deal with sin one day. And now I would hope as I mean, there's no one that I would ever want to see have to deal with that punishment that sinners will deal with one day without the grace of Christ. And, you know, the Bible says vengeance is the Lord's, and it is. But you, sister, have got to allow this thing to go, because you know what forgiveness is? Forgiveness is destroying the power of the offense. Because the offense and the offender have power over you right now. It's destroying you as a person. You may have heard the saying, unforgiveness is like taking poison, expecting the other person to die. This thing is destroying you, and it's not okay, because you're a child of God. You're loved by the King, and God has a great plan for you, and he needs you to raise up and be that mother you can be for your children. He needs you to, you know, he's the rock, but we are to live our lives founded on that rock, based on that rock. And if you're not on that rock and you're being swayed and you're being pulled and you're being depressed and you have all these emotions, that is going to affect your children. But if the mother, their mother that they look up to, can stand on that rock and say, my joy, my peace, my strength, my hope was never in a man. It's always been in Christ, and Jesus is still Lord. Then what they're going to do is they're going to see that, and they're going to say, man, what is going on with mom? There's something in her. I need it. She's never swayed. She's never moved. She's never beaten. She's never, you know, the Bible says that we've been pushed in on all sides, but not crushed. You know, the Bible tells us that the things that we go through, that they do not make us who we are. The Bible says you're a new creation. Behold, all things have passed away, and all things have become new, and all things are of God. You know, we're persecuted but not destroyed. I mean, there's so many different scriptures that tells us that there are. God never said the storms were not going to come, but he said, I'll be with you through those storms. He never said it was going to be easy, but he said it would be worth it. So what we need you to do, I can pray with you and I can, you know, break a spirit of depression off of you or whatever. But the thing about it is you ain't going to stay free until you rise up and become free and take what God has already purchased for you, what Christ has already purchased for you. The Bible says where the Spirit of God is, there's liberty. See, what people don't understand, because they see me doing a lot of deliverances and whatnot, is I understand the power of deliverance, but I also understand that deliverance is not the answer. Jesus is. Deliverance and prayer is not the answer. Jesus is. And when we're nowhere around and you can't get a hold of us, then what are you going to do? You got to go to him. You got to go to the Lord, and you got to go to the Lord, and you got to say, God, I am here and I am your child. And God, I need you. I need your help. Make me who you want me to be. Take me from this place of despair and put me on that rock where I'm supposed to be. Allow my identity to no longer come from this thing anymore, because I'm going to leave it under the blood and I'm going to move forward in faith. And if you want to see your relationship reconciled with your husband, then you get on your knees and you pray and you seek God until it happens. But if you don't, because listen, there's only one excuse I can find in the whole entire Bible for divorce, and that's adultery. And I don't want to see you allow yourself to being pulled, your heartstrings being pulled anymore over the situation, because you are living your life based on emotions. And the Bible says all wisdom any wisdom that's not from God is sensual and demonic, meaning it's all about feelings and emotions. But God wants to take you, and he wants to set you so free from yourself that you're free from others. And no matter what anyone says or anyone does, they cannot make you hate them. They cannot make you be angry or bitter towards them, because your love comes from knowing him, knowing the Father. See, I love people no matter what. I have the people say the nastiest, meanest, evil things about me, but it doesn't change the way I feel about them, because I never loved them because they were saying the right things about me or doing the right things towards me. I love them because God has made me love, because that's his image, and he took me and put me, made me back into that image of love. And that's the answer, sweetheart. That's the key to this. The gospel. It's the gospel, the transforming power of Jesus Christ to transform you from being broken, abused, lost, you know, twisted perspective. And through all of that, he sees you for your eternal destiny, you know, your value. He sees you for your, he sees you, he has predestined you before the foundations of the world to be holy and blameless. He sees you through all of that. He sees you for who you really are. And that's really what repentance is, okay? Repentance is saying that even though I have been here, which is basically, you know, at the bottom, where all the bad stuff is, where the stuff that's just going to destroy you. And I want to move up here to have the perspective of God. You know, repentance is like the penthouse. Where's the penthouse? The very top floor. That's what repentance is, to move up to the top and to no longer be down at the bottom with that perspective, like everything is above you. And because the Bible says, take heart, for Jesus has overcome the world. But I see what you're allowing the world to overcome you. Okay? Now, hating someone is not seeing them for their value and creative purpose and destiny. So if you hate someone, it's because you don't see them for their true value. You don't see them for who they can truly become. So that's why Jesus said, if you've hated in your own heart, you've already murdered. Why? Because you've destroyed and killed them by no longer seeing them for who God made them to be. And this is why Jesus says that, or it says in Romans, it says that when we're baptized into Christ, we're raised into newness of life. So because of newness of life, he sees your value and your destiny through all your faults and all your failures. And the Bible says that we have been given the ministry of reconciliation. It says in Corinthians, it says, it's as if God was pleading through Christ, be reconciled to God. That means to get someone to exchange the old, broken, lost, hurting person for one who has value, purpose, and destiny. That's the answer. That's the key. So that's what we need to do today. Does that make sense? I know that's a lot, but my heart hurts for you, and I really want you to get this.
No, I understand. That's what I was thinking, because there's a side of me that says, you know, I don't care, I hate him, and then the other side says, but you can't do that. You're going to go to hell, and you're not going to pray, and then he's going to go to hell, and you're going to go with him because you're bitter and unforgiving, you know.
Okay, so you understand that forgiveness is not saying that you agree with what he did, and you're not saying, you know, you don't have to. I don't like to say you can forgive, but don't forget. I don't like to say that, because you should forgive, and forgive so much that you do forget to where it's just completely behind you. So forgiveness, but forgiveness is not saying it's okay what you did, and, you know, and allow yourself to be put in that situation again. Forgiveness is saying, I'm not going to allow this to affect my life any longer, and I'm not going to allow this to affect my relationship with my Father any longer. Does that make sense?
Yes.
Okay. So, sweetheart, will you pray with me?
Yes.
Okay. Now, when we're done, were you listening to what I was saying to the lady a couple times ago who was also dealing with depression?
Yes.
Okay, great. Okay, because when I'm done praying with you, I want you to go into a place of intimacy with the Father. I'm not talking about just praying for a set amount of time. I'm talking about communing with the Father until you get up and you realize that you changed. you realize your heart has been changed. You've been changed from the inside out. It's about you know, intimacy and communing with the Holy Spirit till you've been transformed. Okay?
Okay.
Okay. All right. Now you have me on speakerphone?
No.
Please do, if you can. Got it?
Hello? Yeah, I got
it. Okay. Okay. Now just receive. I'm going to pray. Father, in Jesus' name, I thank you, God, for who you are. And I thank you, Father, for what you're about to do in this sister's life. Thank you, God, for the freedom that you're going to give her. The freedom that you've already purchased through the cross. Lord, I just ask that that would manifest in her life. I ask that that grace would pour out upon her right now. Devil, listen to me. You've had your way with this sister enough. She's a child of God. So I bind you right now. Strong man, I bind you. There's another strong man coming in. Jesus Christ. I command you right now. Spirit of depression, come up and come out now. Fire of God. Get out right now. Loose her right now. Broken heart. Loose her in Jesus' name. You've tormented her long enough. I command you to come up out of the heart right now. I command every wound of the heart be healed in Jesus' name. Spirit of depression, go. Out, out, out. Go. Come out right now. Come out. Come out. Come out. Fire in the stomach right now in Jesus' name. Fire in the stomach. Fire, 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 fire. I burn you devils out of your hiding places right now. Every unclean spirit, I tear you out with force. I send strong rebukes in there, and I tear you out and cast you back to the pits of hell where you belong. Look at the Lord Jesus Christ and go where he tells you to go. Out! Thank you, Father. Fire of God all through your body right now in Jesus' name. Fire of God right now to burn up all the strongholds. I tear all the hooks out right now. Every hook of depression, I tear you out right now in Jesus' name. Cancel your assignment. Loose her. Loose her. Loose her. Get out. 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 All torment of the mind, I destroy it right now. I break the power of all torment of the mind right now in Jesus' name. Father, I just release peace. The peace of God, the presence of the Holy Spirit, the presence of Christ, the comfort of the Holy Spirit. I just loose it over her right now in Jesus' name. Fire from head to toe. Fire from head to toe. Fire from head to toe in Jesus' name. Anything unclean, I burn you with the fire of God. I torture you ruthlessly. No rest for you. You come out right now. Come out of the heart. Come out of the stomach and go to the pit in Jesus' name. Come up out of the mouth now. Jesus Christ is Lord. You must obey. Go, go right now. We as the children of God, we command you right now to come up out of her and go to the pit now in Jesus' name. Out of the stomach, out of the stomach, out of the stomach right now. Out, 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 out. Can you hear me, sister?
Yeah, and I felt a cramp.
Where?
I had
your stomach?
Yeah.
Okay, did you get it out? Or is it still there?
It's gone.
It's gone? Hallelujah. Okay, lift your hands up now, okay? Father, in Jesus' name, I thank you for setting her free. Right now, God, I just ask you to pour out your fire, the fire of God from head to toe. Now, fire! In Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, God. Say, Father. Sister, say, Father.
Father.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
I repent of all my sin.
I repent of all my sins.
All my depression.
All my depression.
And all unbelief.
And all unbelief.
I choose to believe you.
I choose to believe you.
And receive your grace and your mercy.
And receive your grace and your mercy.
I ask you right now.
I ask you right now.
Come and make your home inside of me.
Father, make your home inside of me.
In your fullness.
In your fullness.
Dwell in me. And give me your peace.
And give me your peace.
That passes all understanding.
That passes all understanding.
I receive you.
I receive you.
And I receive healing.
And I receive healing.
In my heart, my mind, and my soul.
In my heart, my mind, and my soul.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus'
okay.
name.
Okay. Tell me when you feel warmth. Thank you, Father. Go, Father. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. Fire.
I do.
Fire. 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 More, God. More. 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 Jesus the Christ sets you free today. Mercy. Mercy has come. Grace has come. Do you feel
it? Yeah, I feel it.
Oh, praise God. It's not an it, sister. It's your daddy. Okay?
Yes. I feel him.
Okay. He loves you so much. All right. I'm going to let you go. I'm going to let him have his way with you. God bless you. Okay?
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
All right, praise God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. And I just wanted to share with the listeners this tidbit that the Lord placed upon my heart. This is an excerpt from the book entitled The Life Story of Lester Sumrall. Okay, Lester did not he was one of God's generals, one of the most well-known men of God in the history of my life and for the last probably 200 years. And the reason I'm sharing this with you folks is because this is something that we all need to be made aware of. It's part of our walk. It's part of who we are. And Lester was called in to the Philippines. There was an international, back then they had, mostly just newspapers. They had radio back then, but not a lot of TV, maybe no TV. I'm not exactly sure the exact date that this occurred, but this was back in that, in the 40s probably. But what had happened was a woman was possessed by demons. Really, really bad. It was so horrible. They had men of many different faiths and denominations come in and pray for her, and it was a horrible kind of a circus that occurred. And the leaders of Manila, the government leaders were in disarray. It was just a huge embarrassment. The woman was. It was very much like a Linda Blair exorcist thing, where she was screaming and crying out. It was a complete demon possession situation. But here's the moral of the story. What's really important for us as believers to understand is that we need to realize that we are at a constant battle with the demonic. We are constantly at battle with the demonic, okay? When we understand that this is our plight, it's part of our life, that there is, in fact, a constant battle going on for our souls, no matter how much we are filled with the Holy Spirit. As a matter of fact, the more you are seeking God, the more the demons want to try to trip you up, the bigger the target that is on your back. That is why I am sharing this with you, folks, because we're all in this together, and we need to understand that until we take matters into our own hands through the blood of Jesus Christ, the price that was paid, we are commanded. If you know your Bible well enough, you will understand, and I can sit here and quote scripture after scripture after scripture, Ephesians 6, 10 through whatever, 12, I can go on and on and on, but that's, not the purpose. What I'm trying to do is get to the point to help people to understand the dynamics when dealing with oppression, depression, spirits of unforgiveness, spirits of anger that we have. Once you are delivered, that is not the end of the battle. That is the beginning of the battle. That is when the war starts. There's a reason why it's called spiritual warfare. Wars do not end because one person says, in the name of Jesus, I command you, get out. It doesn't work like that. That's when the war starts. It is up to the believer to take the battle to the demonic and to talk to the mountain on their own. Okay, we must stand for ourselves. We must stand against the demonic forces, and we must proclaim the blood of Jesus over us, and we must declare in Jesus' name that the glory of God and that the peace that passes all understanding will be in our our lives, that the blood of Jesus is pled upon us, we declare it with our lips. That is part of our lives. That is who we are. Okay, because we are the biggest target of the devil on the face of the earth. The unbelievers offer no target whatsoever. The devil could care less. The unbelievers are in his hands. It is us that threaten the devil. Okay, now let me share it with this with you. This is vital for us all to know. It is that this is why when I'll give you some examples, and you can look this up on your own in your own electronic Bible. When Jesus healed the one individual, he said to them, "Now go and sin no more, lest a worse thing come upon thee." What he is saying is that if you go back into sin, if you allow sinful thoughts, thoughts of hatred, thoughts of anger, thoughts of negativity into your heart, you have slipped back into sin, lest a worse thing come upon you. You have at that point invited the demons back into your life. You will go back into depression, lest a worse thing come upon you, and the situation will be much, much worse than it was after you had been delivered. That is why we have to take matters into our own hands as believers. In the Lester Summerall book, it's location 2722 in the Kindle version. But what had happened was he had been told by the Lord to go into the prison cell where this demonically possessed woman was. And it took 2 days and fasting to get this powerful group of demons to leave this woman. And finally, to the absolute astonishment of the Manilan government and the people on the radio shows that were broadcasting it worldwide, the devil and the demons had released a woman and she was set free. It absolutely blew the mind of everybody because they had several different denominations and men of faith from different religions and religious groups try, and they all failed. It was Lester who had no denomination but only the power of Jesus on his side, and the power of Jesus and him and the faith cast the demons out. The demons left. Here's the problem. The demons came back. People, in the name of Jesus, we must understand that deliverance is step one. That begins the war. Now, here's what happened. I'm going to read this excerpt from the book. Okay, Lester was beside himself because he did not like dealing with demons. He did not like deliverance. It was the least liked thing that he did when he worked for the Lord. He hated it. But God said, if you don't go, I have no one else in this city to send. And he bowed before the Lord, and out of obedience, he went in. The demons came back. It was humiliating and embarrassing to everyone, and the woman was repossessed with demons. He was sitting in her presence, and he said, and I quote, this is a quotation from the book, "I ordered the demons to tell me why they had returned. They spoke in English through her lips. 'She has not asked us to go. She wants us. It is only you who desires us to leave.' Again, I demanded that they leave her. Clarita told me that they were gone through the window. I explained to her why they returned and told her to tell them to leave and never return, and she did. Then I led her in prayer, pleading the blood of Jesus against them. It was about noon. Clarita was weak from the ordeal. I told the prison officials to let her rest and to give her food, and as I was leaving, I said, 'Clarita, I am sure these devils will return again. After I am gone, they will come. You must order them to leave without me being present to help you. You must say, go in the name of Jesus, and they will obey.'" Folks, this one paragraph from that book, The Life Story of Lester Summerall, I would argue is by far, bar none, the single most important lesson that every single person dealing in healing, which is 99 to probably 95% of all sicknesses and psychological problems are demonic. There's a small exception, all right? But as a general rule, 90%+ are demonic. Okay, and that includes depression and everything else under the sun. It's a battle. It's a war. And if you don't take that war into your hand, claim and plead the blood of Jesus, use some holy oil, put the holy oil on your forehead in the morning, get on your knees and say, I consecrate myself to the complete ownership of the Lord Jesus Christ. I claim this healing in the name of Jesus. I claim this deliverance in the name of Jesus. I declare the love and the glory and the peace of God that passes all understanding upon my life. I declare forgiveness and love upon myself and upon all those who have done me wrong. I claim it in the name of Jesus. Demons of death, I rebuke you. We must take the battle to the devil, each and every one of us. Deliverance and healing is only step one. Praise Jesus. All right, and on that note, we'll go to the next person on the call list. Praise God. Praise Jesus. Hallelujah. 0115, last four. You're on live with Pastor Aaron Wagner.
Hi, my name is Dave.
Hi, Dave.
And I'm calling. Hi. And I'm calling for actually three things. I have MS and I have lower back issues, and I'm struggling on getting that fire for God. And I mean, some days I have it, some days I don't. I just would like some prayer.
Okay. So let me address the issue of the fire, because I hear that a lot. And my first question is, when you lose the fire, where does it go? We equate being on fire with God as a feeling, as a rise of emotion, maybe even a passion. Well, I tend to, as the scriptures say, you know, move towards the fact that the Bible says we walk by faith, not by sight. You want fire? The way that you get fire is, number one, you got to know God. You have to know him. I'm not talking about going to church. I'm not talking about reading your Bible. I'm not talking about just prayer time. I'm talking about intimacy, fellowship, communion with God. See, a lot of us, we say, well, I did pray. I prayed for an hour today, right? You know, I had my prayer time this morning. My prayer time was a half hour, you know, this morning, and I got through my prayers. And we don't realize that when I'm talking about praying, I'm not talking about spending an hour in prayer. I'm talking about getting alone with God and just telling him how amazing he is, how thankful you are for what he's done in your life, the transforming power of his grace, and you just commune with him. And it's not always, because a lot of times we go to God is when we need something from him. A lot of times our prayer time is in the morning. We wake up and we say, because we only got 4, 5, 6 hours of sleep the night before, and our prayer time is, God, this is going to be a heck of a day without you. God, I need you. I need your strength. Lord, I need this. I need that. Lord, help me with this and help me with that. And it's all about asking and asking. Just think about, if you're married, which I am, if the only time I talk to my wife is when I needed something, I don't think I'd have a very strong marriage. And so the fire, I've had so many people ask me, how are you so on fire for God? Because I've been walking with the Lord for 7 years, and when I first came to the Lord, within that year, I had so many people tell me, well, brother, you know, this fire, you know, you got to realize it's a marathon, you know, it's not a sprint, you got to slow down, and you know, one of these days, you're not going to have that fire is just because you're new, and this and that. And I know that the fact is, it's not a marathon, it's not a sprint, it's a race. And I have, and I'm more on fire today than I ever have been. And the reason that I give for that, number one, it's the grace of God. Number two, it's knowing him. You cannot know him without being on fire. No one can tell me different. No one can tell me God don't love me. No one can tell me that God is angry with me and is going to send me to hell. No one can tell me I'm going to lose my salvation from something I did. No one can, because I don't need to hear anything from you. You cannot pull me down. You can't pull me away from God. You can't hurt me. The only thing you can do is cheer me on. That's it. Because even if you say, no matter what you say, you're not going to change my mind about God because I know him. No matter what you say, no matter what you do, is not going to change how I feel about the Lord. It's, you need to, like I say over and over again, it's about spending time with the Lord, fellowship with him. And the Bible says that when Jesus comes, he will what? He will baptize you in water and the Holy, or sorry, you'll be baptized with the Holy Spirit and with fire. He didn't come to baptize you in water. He came to baptize you with the Holy Ghost and fire. So I don't know if you've been baptized in the Holy Ghost and fire, but if you have, that fire doesn't leave you. It stays. So there was a time in my life where I would only pray for people, pray for the sick, you know, do amazing, you know, exploits for God when I would get this fire in my chest. All of a sudden I'd feel this heat and it'd go into my chest, and then I knew God wanted me to do something. Well, one day I was at church and God told me to get up, and there was many, many people there. And he said, I'm about ready to use you. You need to get up. And I stand up, and I didn't know what to do because there was no one else. I didn't know what he wanted me to do. And all of a sudden, I got the fire in my chest. Wham! I knew he was about to do something. All of a sudden, the whole church just starts walking up to the front and lines up across the whole front of the place. I get up on the stage area where they were all standing. And this is way before I was actually preaching in a church. And I would just stretch my hand out, and people were just falling out on the power of God. Bam, bam, bam. People were getting set free. People were getting healed. I would just move my hand across, and four or five people would fall down all at once. And I had that fire in my chest. I had that passion and that grit. And I was so excited. I didn't even want to sleep that night. I just wanted to pray for people. I just wanted to touch people because everybody I was touching, everybody I was praying for was falling down. And it was just amazing because it was really the first time I ever really seen it in such a powerful way. Well, then the next time I was going to minister, I'm waiting. God, where's that fire? I don't feel the fire. Next time after that, no fire, no fire, no fire. I wasn't feeling it. And the Lord told me, he said, the reason that I gave you that fire that time was so that you would get up and act out who you already are. You are already anointed. You already have the fire. Stop basing it off feelings. It's not about a feeling. And then there was a time in my life where 6 months went by where every time I'd worship, I wouldn't even feel the presence of God. And I was the type of guy where I'd go in the presence of God, worship for 5 minutes, and be down and not even be able to move. Because of worship, and God would just overtake me, and there was no presence of God. I would not feel him, and I'm in instant condemnation because I was young in the faith. God, why don't I feel you? What did I do? Did I do something wrong? God, I can't do this no more. I have to. And I realized God told me, you're worshiping me, not for me, but for you, so you can get a feeling. And so once I had that realization, I repented of it. And I went in and I started worshiping. Then I started feeling the presence of God again. God never wants us to live our life in him based off of how we feel. It's dangerous and it's demonic. Because God is never going to make us or give us what we need in order to live by sensuality. He wants you to believe and trust that you have fire even when you don't feel it. He wants you to believe that you are who you are even when you're not feeling like it. Even when you don't have that, you know, what Christians call the anointing or fire. Because it doesn't lift. It doesn't go anywhere. So every day what you do, do what I do. Wake up. Father, I thank you for who I am. Or thank you for who you are. Thank you for who I am. God, thank you that I am your son and I am on this earth to do your will. Thank you that I've been predestined before the foundations of the world to be conformed to the image of Christ. And God, I thank you for the fire that is within me. Thank you that I'm anointed. And you look in the mirror and you say, God is in you. And you remind yourself, God is in you. Doesn't matter what you feel. You will, as I talked about earlier, it's about a perspective. Perspective. You let your perspective get twisted and you begin to not believe that God's with you because you don't feel him, you're going to feel condemned all the time. Okay? So, remember, in the kingdom, you get what you believe. So just allow yourself to come back to that place where you praise God. Thank you, God, that you'll never leave me nor forsake me. Thank you, God, for perfect love.
Yeah. I'm amening you big time, brother, because that's covered by in the book Charles and Frances Hunter. Frances says that exact same thing. She says that it is Christ. I'm totally paraphrasing, but it is ultimately the Spirit of Jesus Christ in us is what allows us to make the confession with our lips through the power of Christ for things that we have faith in. Faith is that which we it's belief in that which we do not see. We do not feel, and we do not have a presence of realization of. That is what faith is, and that profession of faith through confession of our lips is the utterance of the power of Christ in us. So when we don't feel it, we stand before, as Brother Curry Blake says, stand in front of the mirror, look it in the mirror and say, I am a son of God. Look at yourself in that mirror and make the confession, because that is the power of Christ in you, and by making that confession, you are manifesting through faith that power in your life. Okay, we don't have to become some kind of freaky deaky new ager, because they got books galore about how you can do, the power of words and how it can change your life. And the sad part about that is that what they're saying is true. The problem is that they don't realize that it's the power of Jesus Christ in us and that confession of faith that changes our lives. Praise God. And you do it even when you don't feel it. Amen, Brother Aaron. Praise God.
Praise God. Amen. And John, like you're saying, when you look in the mirror and you say that, what happens is you begin to believe it. You see, that's really what it's about. The Bible says that when you look in the Bible and you walk away and you forget who you are, you're like a man who looked in the mirror and totally forgot, or what you read, or you don't put it in action. You're actually a man who looks in the mirror and forgets who he is. Well, you go back to the mirror and you remember who you are. And so the more you look in that mirror, you continue to remember who you are. Now, that's with the Bible and actually looking at who you are and telling yourself, listen, this is who you are. And you're actually training your brain, which is what? Renewing the mind, being renewed in your mind. You're training your brain to believe and to trust in what God has already said about you. So praise God. That's awesome. All right, brother. So I just wanted to address that. And I hope you got something out of that. Because ultimately, I believe that you are on fire. I believe that the reason that you called is because you have the fire of God in you. You have the Spirit of God in you, and you're hungering for Him. But you're using it. And that hunger is turning into condemnation, rather than the fire that God has already given you to fuel you on.
Yeah.
Amen. It's just like when people, they're Christian and they live out their life in Christianity and they're doing so good, they're rock solid for, good 2 years, and then all of a sudden, they make a stupid mistake and they just condemn themselves and, man, you don't understand. I there's no way I'm a Christian if I've done this, and I really, really messed up. And I'm not saying this to any way empower someone to sin. But I'm saying if you've already made that mistake, don't condemn yourself, repent of it, and be thankful that your heart has been changed to the way that it can even be condemned. Because before you could care less whether or not you sinned. You could care less if you made that mistake, but now God is transforming your heart so much that it hurts to even sin, because that's ultimately what this thing is about. It's about allowing yourself to be transformed by God so much so that now all of a sudden you are aware of what you were not aware of before. So that crying out of yours to be on, to stay on fire is actually the fact, it's evidence that you are on fire. But it's not about doing. It's not about doing fire. It's about being. It's who you are. You're already that person. So you just got to live out of that. Does that make sense?
Yeah, it does.
Awesome. Okay, so kind of, John and I just kind of went on a tangent there, but that, these are touchy subjects, man. People are, bringing up some stuff that really matters in the body of Christ, and we just want to see people rise up and become, the body of Christ, because we're the bride, and we're all one body, and when the other brothers suffer, brothers and sisters suffer, we suffer, because we're all one body. So, now, the other thing was the MS. Okay, now I got to give you this, because there's this brother who heard me on this show, and I didn't know him from Adam, but he called me, or he emailed me, and I called him back, and he told me he had multiple sclerosis, and he wasn't able to work because he was he was on disability, and he was really having a hard time, and you know, making it. He was struggling, everything. He was in and out of a wheelchair, and when I prayed for him, the fire of God hit him, and he's been, and this is over the phone, and he's been healed ever since. And every day he'd message me and tell me, I feel better today. I feel better today. I feel better. He just got better and better and better as the days went on. And now he's completely free from multiple sclerosis, and he's not in that wheelchair, and he's back to work. Praise God. He's a
wow.
listener of this show. So I've seen
wow.
multiple sclerosis beat before. Hallelujah.
Amen.
All right. Do you have me on speakerphone?
Yep.
Okay, I'm up for you. I'm going to set you free from this nasty disease. It's a lie, okay?
Cool.
All right. Devil, I bind you by the – wait, let me ask you a question. Is somebody with you right now?
No.
Okay. Do you know if – it's okay. Never mind. I just want to – I feel like one of your left leg is shorter than your right. Do you know about that?
I think my right leg is shorter than my left.
Oh, really? Wow.
I think it is.
Okay.
I've been getting, I got lower back pain,
yeah.
but also in my hips are,
okay.
So I really don't know for sure.
Man, that's weird. I was hearing it in my heart. I'm usually never wrong on that, but I could be. I'm not. I mean, yeah. Why don't we just we'll just straighten up your back, and God will move out whatever leg needs to be moved, and then we'll pray for this multiple sclerosis, and you're going to be a powerful testimony to everybody who listens to this. All right. So, Father, right now in Jesus' name, God, I just thank you for this brother, and thank you that you love him. I speak to the bones in your back. I speak to every muscle and every nerve in the entire back. I command you, relax and go into place. I command every disc, every vertebrae in the entire spine. I command you, go to place now. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name, right now, I command the pelvis, I command you, rotate and go into place now. Back, every bone of the waist area, command you, be restored, be healed, be made whole, and go into place in Jesus' name. Thank you, Father. Tell me if you're feeling movement in your legs or anything.
My lower back, it just is really warm, really warm.
That's awesome. Praise God. He's
yeah.
so good to us.
Actually, Pastor, when we were talking, or when you were talking before, I could feel in my backside just everything warm and tingly. It before you even prayed
yeah.
for me, and it was awesome.
Yeah, isn't that great? I get that a lot. That's the mercy of God, and he's trying to teach you who you are. And through the Bible says our words are life, and everything I was speaking to you was life, and that was life just going into you and just restoring you. That's great. I'm just gonna pray for that multiple sclerosis to leave your body, and it's going to. Because Jesus is Lord, okay? Praise
Amen.
God. Thank you, Lord, for what you're doing. So right now, in Jesus' name, devil, you're bound. I bind you right now by the power of the Spirit of God. Spirit of infirmity, I command you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ to come up and come out now. Infirmity. I tear you out right now. Come up out of the stomach and go to the pit in Jesus' name. Come out! Out! You spirit of death, you spirit of multiple sclerosis, get out! By the power and the blood of Jesus Christ, you gotta go right now. Multiple sclerosis, you're a lie. Get out of this man in Jesus' name. Now, come out of the nervous system. Come out of the body now in Jesus' name. Out. Out. Loose him. Loose him. I tear you out with force. I tear you out. It's time to come up and come out right now. Go to the pit where you belong. Go back to the pits of hell where you belong in Jesus' name. You're defeated by the blood of the cross. Caught, you've been found out. You have to go. You nasty, filthy, stinking disease. You're defeated. You and all your little symptoms, you come out and go to the pit now. Out. 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 Fire of God from head to toe in Jesus' name. I just burn that disease out. I burn all those symptoms out in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I curse that disease right at the root, and it has to go and not come back in Jesus' name, because Jesus Christ is Lord. Papa, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, God. Hallelujah. God, thank you. Out, 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 out. Something's going on, man. I feel it in the spirit. What's going on?
Oh, I feel great. I feel great.
yeah?
It's almost like a cold sweat.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah. So do you feel kind of like intense tingling all over?
Oh yeah, especially in my ankles, my legs.
Yeah, so that's usually a manifestation of that demon leaving. It feels good because that thing's been draining your life for so long. It's been sucking life out. So get out, you spirit of death. Get out. Get out right now. You cannot stay. Come up and come out. Your time is up. Jesus Christ sets this man free today. Go.
Amen.
The blood of Christ is against you. Out. 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 I speak to you right now by the authority of Jesus Christ. It's time to go. Multiple sclerosis, spirit of infirmity, come out of this body. Now. Out. Nothing left. Nothing behind. Get out. I command the resurrection power of Jesus Christ to enter into every cell of your body right now until you're fully restored. The sin is gone. The sin is forgiven. So the effects of sin, the curse is broken today from this day forth. As a son of God, that curse, it's done. Loose him. Loose him. Loose him in Jesus' name. You're in trouble now, multiple sclerosis. You've been caught. You got to go. Can't stay behind. Can't stay behind. Out. 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 All the poison in his stomach, whatever you demons have been feeding him, I burn it with fire right now. I burn it with fire in Jesus' name. Out of the stomach. Come up out of the stomach. Come out of the stomach right now. Go, 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 go. Come out of the stomach and go to the pit in Jesus' name. I see you in there. I see what you've been feeding them. Come out right now. Out. Out. Out of the stomach. Out of the stomach. I pour the blood of Jesus down his throat into his stomach right now. The blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus. Drink it all down, demons. It's time to go. It's time to go. Father, I ask you to send a fire shock right to the top of his head, to the bottom of his feet, in Jesus' name. Any unclean spirit, any demon, Holy Spirit, I ask you to replace those spirits. Fill them up, Holy Spirit. Fill them up. Fill them up. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, God. Okay, lift your hands up, brother. Say, Father, okay. Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
I repent for all sin.
I repent for all sins.
And all doubt.
And all doubt.
Of who you are.
And who you are.
And who I am.
And who I am.
I now know.
I now know.
I'm a child of God.
I'm a child of God.
Child of the King.
Child of the King.
So I ask you, empower me.
For I ask you, empower me.
To live that way.
To live that way.
From this day forth.
From this day forth.
I ask you, restore the fire.
I ask that you restore the fire.
And make me as passionate about you.
And make me as passionate for you.
As you are for me.
As you are for me.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen. All right, Father, more, 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 more. Pour into him, God. Pour into him. Fire, 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 fire. Holy Spirit, invade every muscle, every tendon, every nerve, every bone. Invade, Holy Spirit. The Spirit gives you life, life, life. I speak life in Jesus' name. I speak healing. I speak restoration and renewal. I speak peace and shalom to every cell of your body right now in Jesus' name. Fire. Thank you, God. You feel his heat yet?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, so you think that thing's gone?
Oh, yeah.
Praise God. Hallelujah. Okay, can I, my email is christislord@me.com. I've only got 16 minutes. I probably got a couple more callers, so I better get to them. Will you email me, please?
Sure. Sure.
Okay, christislord@me.com. All one word, christislord@me.com. Okay?
Okay. Got it.
Okay. Bless you, brother.
Hey, thank you very much.
Absolutely. Thank Jesus. He's your healer.
Praise
okay?
Jesus. Hallelujah.
Oh, he touched me. Oh,
all right. Praise God. Last four, 2156. You're on live with Pastor Aaron Wagner. 2156.
Hello?
You're live.
Hello?
Yeah, I got you.
Oh, hi. Hey, Pastor Aaron, this is Nick. You prayed for me about 5-6 weeks ago. I was diagnosed last year with Syndrome X, which is a metabolic syndrome disorder, which can cause all sorts of problems with your digestive
Nick
tract.
Oh, Nick from Seattle?
Yep, that's me.
How you doing, brother? So you're the one with the stomach problems, right?
Yes, yes.
Okay, awesome. I already know your situation. Put your hand on your stomach. Let's pray.
All right, let's do it.
All right, Father, in Jesus' name, I thank you for Nick, God, and I thank you that you love him so much. God, thank you for grace that is going to heal him right now and make him whole. I command this situation to be destroyed. I command this attack on his body to cease in the name of Jesus. Stomach lining, be healed, be made whole. Every cell of your body be restored in Jesus' name. Stomach, body, be healed. Thank you, Jesus. Delus him right now. Fire of God. Fire of God. Fire of God in Jesus' name. Thank you, Father, for brand new in Jesus' name. Thank you for no more sickness, God. Thank you for no more suffering. Because Jesus is Lord. Are you feeling a manifestation?
Not yet.
Okay, do you have me on speakerphone?
Yes, you do. I know the drill.
Okay.
All right.
Be healed right now in Jesus' name. I want you to just say, thank you, Father, for my healing.
Thank you, God, for my healing.
Thank you for making me whole.
Thank you for making me whole.
The children's bread.
The children's bread.
I receive it.
I receive it.
I receive everything you purchased for me, Lord.
I receive everything that you purchased for me, Lord.
It's by your grace I'm healed.
It's by your grace I am healed.
and I am free.
And I am free.
I can't deserve it.
I can't deserve it.
I can't earn it.
I can't earn it.
I receive it.
I receive it by your grace.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
All right, you have your hand on, keep your hand on your stomach for a minute.
Yeah, I do feel an intense amount of heat from my right hand right now, because my right hand's on my stomach.
Yeah, because you have the Spirit of God in you, and He's healing through you, not through me. He's healing through
you.
That's
right.
Because you're a son of God, bro.
That's right.
All right, so I'm gonna get to the next callers. Praise God for your healing, okay?
All right. Thank you, and thank you, Johnny.
In the name of Jesus, hallelujah. In the name of Jesus, praise God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Fire upon your stomach in Jesus' name.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Praise God. Hallelujah. I love it. I love it. Praise you, Jesus.
Oh, yeah.
Six 602, last four. 6802. You're on live with Pastor Aaron Wagner.
Hello, Pastor Aaron.
Hello, brother.
I'm calling because I've had hemorrhoids for about 40 years, and they bleed significantly, and I need your help.
Okay. 4 years, huh?
Yes.
Wow. All right. Let's curse that thing, man. I'm not trying to be weird, but put your hand where, you know, kind of where it's at.
Okay.
Just kind of lay it over. Father, I thank you right now in Jesus' name. Thank you for this call. Thank you for what you're about to do. Right now, in the mighty name of Jesus, I curse these hemorrhoids. I command them to shrivel up and die in Jesus' name. No more pain, no more suffering. Skin, be healed, be made whole. Every cell of your skin, be made whole in Jesus' name. Father, thank you for your grace. Thank you for mercy. Thank you for touching him right now and making him whole. In Jesus' name, be healed. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Devil, if there's any unclean spirits attached to this, I rebuke you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. It's time to go. Loose him. Fire on you, devils, right now. Out! Out, you spirits! Jesus Christ is Lord. Devil, loose him now. I break your power. I cancel your assignments against him. I break every curse off of him. I break every attack against him in Jesus' name. Fire from head to toe right now in Jesus' name. The Lord sets him free today. What are you feeling, brother? You feeling some warmth?
I'm really hot. I'm sweating like crazy.
Okay. Right now, loose him right now. Loose him. Loose him. Loose him. Go. Go. Go! Out! Out, you spirits! Let him go right now in Jesus' name. Fire of God. Fire of God. Fire of God. Fire in his stomach. Fire in his stomach. Fire in his stomach in Jesus' name. Fire all through the stomach right now. Loose him, devils. Loose him, your spirits. Loose him! You've been caught. You've been found out. You got to go in Jesus' mighty name. Jesus Christ is Lord. Father, I ask for your holy fire to come down right now and sanctify this vessel and make it clean. Fire of God right now from head to toe. Fire of God in Jesus' name. Fire of God in Jesus' name. Holy Spirit, I thank you that I've cursed this thing and it has to die. Thank you, Lord. More, God, more. Pour into him. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Pour into this man. More, more, more.
I'm shaking uncontrollably.
What's that?
Praise Jesus. He's shaking uncontrollably. Hallelujah. Praise
you. So, John, I need this guy's number. I need his number. Can you write it down for me?
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Yes, I can. And I got it.
Okay. Okay, thank you so much. Okay, brother. Fire. Do we have more callers, John? Fire.
Yes, we
fire.
Do. Praise Jesus. Hallelujah. And we're moving on. And hallelujah.
Okay.
Thank you,
I'm
going to
call you right back, brother. I'm going to call you back, okay? God bless you.
Five, three, four, six. Last four. You're on live with Pastor Aaron Wagner. 5346. 5346. Praise Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. 5346. My goodness, this poor person has been on. Maybe they're just listening. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I saw they were on for so long. Praise God. All right, let's go ahead and move on. 7380. 7380. You're on live with Pastor Aaron Wagner. 7380. Last four. Okay, could be that a lot of people are listening. It's very common. A lot of people like to call in and listen. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. All right, let's go ahead and hold on. Put 7380 on hold. And let's just double check. Wait a minute. Okay, we got 0713. You're on live with Pastor Aaron Wagner. Are you there? 0713.
Hello?
Yep,
hello?
You're live with Pastor
hello?
Aaron Wagner.
We've only got a few minutes, so go ahead and tell me what you need, dear. Bless you.
And let's just double check. Wait a minute. Okay, we got 0713.
Can you hear me, sweetheart?
Hello. Can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you fine. Yes.
Oh, okay. Hi there.
Hi.
I'm getting feedback. That's why.
Oh.
I'm getting a little bit of feedback here, but
oh.
I'll quickly tell you I went to a meeting. It's not for me, but I went to a meeting and there was a boy there that's been brain vegetable dead for quite a while, and I'm just
I told the
mother that I'm believing that God will touch this boy and heal him.
Absolutely.
So by faith, I'm just believing that he will be healed. He can't do anything. He's a vegetable.
So if you could email me. Yes, I agree with you. Email me and we'll pray with you, okay? Because I want to kind of deal with people that are right now that need an issue, because some people have been waiting on the line for a long time. So
okay, no problem.
I will pray with you. ChristIsLord@me.com, okay?
Okay, thank you.
Okay, I love you, sweetheart. I'm sorry. This is nothing against you, okay?
No, not at all. It's just I'll email you, and then maybe you could just pray, come in agreement with me for him.
Amen. Absolutely. Sounds good.
Okay.
Bless you.
Thank
Bye-bye.
You. Bye-bye.
Yes, amen. Praise God. And we are down to the last 5 minutes of the show, Pastor Aaron, if you want to go ahead and close with a word for the people. I'm looking at the call queue right now. Now let me just double check. I do believe that I've hit all the calls, but I'm going to try one more just real quick. 7380, last four. Are you there? 7380. 7380.
Praise God. And we are down to the last 5 minutes.
Hello?
7380.
The people. I'm looking at the call queue right now. Let me just double check.
Okay.
Okay, praise God. So go ahead, if you would, Pastor Aaron, and close with the prayer for us. We're down to the last 4 minutes of the program. Praise Jesus.
Okay, I want to just tell everybody, if you didn't get, if we didn't get to you this time, go ahead and call in next time. We'll be live again in 2 weeks. Or if it's a really serious issue, you have my email, and if I get back to you in time, then praise God. Can't guarantee it, but I'll definitely try. I'm going to pray for just kind of a general prayer for every person who's listening, for God to just see your need and meet you where you're at. I believe with all my heart that that's what he wants to do, because he just loves us so much. So, Father, I just thank you right now, God, for God, who you are, God. This is all possible because of who you are, because you're so good and you're so merciful and so loving, God. Father, we thank you for the people that you have touched tonight. You touch so many people, God, all by your grace, people are free. And Father, we thank you right now for those who did not get to, for those who have needs but are afraid to call in. Maybe there's a problem and they're not able to call in. God, I'm just asking for grace and mercy to pour out from heaven right now and touch them right where they're at. Father, for healing, every person under the sound of my voice, I command every disease, every sickness, every infirmity, every weakness of the flesh, whether it be depression, oppression, fear, anxiety, all those things, in Jesus' name, I curse you and command you, leave by the power of the blood of Christ, by the power of the cross. The cross has defeated you, and we are free. Where the Spirit of God is, there's liberty. So, Holy Spirit, I'm just asking you to pour out upon the people. I'm asking you to touch the people and set their hearts on fire. Set them on fire for you, Lord God. I'm asking you, great Father, for greater intimacy, greater relationship, stronger communion between you and your people, God. For all those under the sound of my voice, I'm asking, Father, that you would teach them who they are. Teach them who you are, Father. I'm asking that you would meet them in their secret place, and that grace would come down and transform them and make them into the image of Jesus Christ. Father, thank you for this platform. Thank you for this ministry. Thank you. I just ask you to continue to bless this ministry. Continue to bless Johnny as he goes forth and gives the word. God, I'm asking truth to prevail through this ministry, that he would speak truth at all costs and prepare your people for what is coming, to prepare your people to rise up and to, when the whole world is covered in darkness, that the light of Christ will be seen upon your people through this ministry, God. And I thank you, Father. I ask for increase, greater revelation, greater knowledge and wisdom. I'm asking for words of knowledge, words of wisdom to just flow throughout this ministry. In Jesus' name, for all those who are behind the scenes, I ask you to bless them and give them peace and give them strength. Give Johnny strength, Lord, to endure, for your grace is sufficient. He needs more of your grace. He's got so much going on. And I just ask, God, that your grace would strengthen him, Father. And I thank you, Lord. We're so thankful for who you are, thankful for what you're doing. We thank you for the cross of Jesus Christ that makes all of this possible. Thank you that you loved us so much that you sent your son to die on a cross for us. Thank you for the blood that was shed. Thank you for the pain that you endured for us, Lord, for the suffering that you endured for us, so that we could be reconciled back to you, our great Father in heaven, in Jesus' name. Anybody who wants to contact me, please contact me at christislord@me.com. And you can also go to my website, which is touchedbyjesus.blogspot.com or touchedbygrace.blogspot.com. It's one of those two. Can't remember exactly, but yeah, we're getting ready to go and bring this truth to the world, to the country. We're going to start in the country. I'm be doing some traveling and whatnot. So if I don't get back to your emails real quick, I'm sorry. I'm just very busy. Please pray for this ministry. Pray for what God is doing through us. And we thank you so much. God bless every one of you.
Thank you, Jesus. Praise God. We covet your prayers, everyone. God bless you all. We will see you Tuesday, June the 7th, Tuesday night, June the 7th, same time, same place. Lord willing, praise Jesus. Thank you, Pastor Aaron. Thank you all. God bless you all.